Imagine this, you order a car from an app and it shows up with no one in the driver's seat. Hi, I'm Mallory, UMX video producer. Remotely operated vehicles have been tested worldwide, mostly in industrial settings, but using them for car sharing is relatively new and experimental. Opinions are mixed. Some doubt remotely operated vehicles will solve bigger issues like car dependency, congestion or pollution, while others see real potential. So what's your take? Today we are at the Port of Antwerp-Bruges, Belgium, to try a unique car rental service launched in February 2025 by Ush and Poppy Mobility, where cars are remotely driven from an office. It's Europe's first revenue-generating driverless operation outside test programs. So let's have a closer look from the passenger seat.
My name is Bartek, and I'm the tail driver here today for the little demo. Clear from the left.
Go ahead.
So no traffic from the right, we're good to go.
Yes. As you can see, this is the remote controlled vehicle. So the driver is located outside of the vehicle in an office where we have our safety driver behind the wheel, making sure everything is safe, and we are now driving. A remote control vehicle is a normal vehicle into which we install hardware that allow a human driver to control the vehicle without having to be inside of the vehicle. A certified human driver is located in an office, so it's a much safer environment where the driver cannot drink, cannot smoke, cannot be on his phone, cannot be distracted. Obviously, connectivity is a critical point. The way it works is we have two modems in the vehicle, so four SIM cards. We automatically select the best network. Before that, we map the connectivity in the area that we're going to launch to know how the connectivity is. Once the vehicle is on the street, and imagine that the connectivity drops below a certain level, then the safety driver will have to take over or the vehicle would stop. Same if we lose complete connectivity, then the vehicle is smart enough that it can stop on it.
Port Area is an open innovation platform. In 2018, we opened up our port as well for remote operated barging technologies. So CIFAR has been active since then, which makes Flanders the cradle for remote shipping. We want to do similar enablement for road operations. If you can operate this kind of technology in a port area, you can do it anywhere.
We're starting at the port because the port is a great location. It's a public road. It is mostly business oriented, so there is no schools and there is no, you know, external factors too much. Once we have established ourselves there, then the idea is to transfer toward the city. We know that Antwerp has very ambitious goals to reduce private cars ownership, and so it's like a natural transition towards the city. The idea is to give mobility for everyone, so therefore go to every city. So
we see that we already have a lack of drivers, shippers, and train conductors in the operational part, and we need to keep our port accessible. So to increase the accessibility and to improve it and to make sure that it will be accessible in the future, we need to invest and support this kind of new technologies.
The service at the port is made so that it facilitates mobility for employees. When an employee finishes their shift, they can order via the Puppy app a vehicle. It's called rental delivery, where we will remotely drive the vehicle to them. Once the vehicle is at the customer can drive it himself, go or herself, wherever they want. We are trying to launch a service. Now that service will have steps, and we are the first steps where the permit that we have is for 1 year, but the intent is to renew that permit and to scale according to the regulations, obviously. The goal is to assess the commercial needs, the business needs, and how we can improve mobility and accessibility of mobility for it.
These remotely operated vehicles are being tested at the Port of Antwerp-Bruges, but its potential could reach much further. Where do you see remotely operated vehicles in 5 years? Drop your predictions in the comments.
The main obstacle, I would say, or the main barrier, is still our legal framework. We don't have legislation yet for the commercial rollout of autonomous vehicles or teleoperated vehicles, but we are working hard on this as we have this roadmap for the rollout of these technologies. We are together with the federal ministry and other regions working hard to realize the ambition, which is to have in the end licenses ready for robot taxis and robot shuttles.
The goal is to corner the entire port. Now we are starting with one specific stretch of roads. This road is about 24 kilometers long and it goes from the north to the south of the port that they can go wherever they want. It is a regular vehicle onto which we installed some hardware, cameras, GPS, antennas, connectivity. The idea is that once the vehicle is equipped, it can be used very soon.
There are many advantages for autonomous vehicles, such as erasing human error, so increased safety, but also extra comfort, also a solution to driver shortages within the transport sector and so on. But there are also possible threats to the introduction of autonomous vehicles. The extra comfort might ensure reversed modal shifts. There might be extra vehicles, kilometers driven, and so the rollout should really support our ambition to have a modal shift by 2030. And the ambition is to have a 50-50 modal split, which means 50% of the mode of transport will be done by car, but 50% should be done by sustainable modes of transport, such as cycling, biking, shared systems and public transport. Europe also has a role to play. They also have a smart and sustainable mobility strategy and they also have regulation in place.
Here the idea is with car sharing is to be able to move a vehicle when there is no demand and to move it where there is a demand. What we intend to do is provide transportation for people living in suburban areas. For example, currently car sharing companies don't go to the suburban areas because there is not enough demand. I think technology allows us to provide a new kind of service, or a new quality of service that wasn't possible before, and we're trying to use the right technology with the right use case to do that.